play. It's here.
Ready, set, go!
Greetings, children of the screen. Your friendly neighborhood nerd scum here once again, coming at you with another quick thoughts video. This time, focusing in on Adventures of the Super Sons, number one. By Tomasi, Barberry, Thibert, and Protobunker. This miniseries takes place in between Super Sons number 16 and Superman Special number 1. Right on, guys, so without any further ado, let's go ahead and dive into The Adventures of the Super Sons number 1. We open with Jonathan Kent returning with a bucket of popcorn, stating, "Sorry, I thought the popcorn place was a lot closer. Are you sure you don't need a hand?" We then reveal Robin engaged in battle with the iconic bronze statue of Superman. After a bit of banter, John lends aid, giving Robin a chance to track down the villain behind controlling the statue, Puppet Master. A crowd rushes up to thank them, but Damian quickly reminds John that it's time for them to be getting to school, and they exit. We then cut to the dark side of the moon as a ship approaches Earth and the commander orders them to go into stealth mode. They are in luck as their targets are out and about, children of the Earth's greatest protectors. Superboy and Robin, the Super Sons, and soon they will be super dead. After school, the boys are picked up via helicopter by Alfred and relocated to their base under Morrison Bay. Superboy carries in several cases of soda, seeing as his parents won't let him drink them at home, but this isn't home now, is it? They then get an alert that a monster is wreaking havoc in the mall of Metropolis, so they gear up and head out with Superboy screaming, "You know what this means? It's the summer of Super!" And Damian, "Seriously, I will pay you $8 million to stop saying that." They arrive at the Mall of Metropolis to find a large hairy beast throwing cars around. They engage with Superboy catching the car and saving the pedestrians, but just then Damian is hit by some kind of projectile that then opens up, wrapping him in restraints. John tries to help but is grabbed up by the beast, and a voice from off-panel says, "Make one move and Kid Deadshot puts one right between his eyes." That is when we reveal the occupants of the ship, the gang. Shaggy Boy, the Beast. Ice Princess, a young female Captain Cold counterpart. Kid Deadshot, Brainiac 6, Joker Jr., and their leader, Rex Luthor, who holds a small white box. Rex exposits that they're big fans of theirs and the so-called villains that they fight, so they decided to organize a little hunting trip. And that is when Rex opens the case, revealing it to be gold kryptonite. Rex smiles maniacally, saying, "One of the rarest minerals in the universe. Rumored to completely depower Kryptonians." John gets weak and falls to his knees. Rex smirks. "You must be feeling so strange right now." As Joker Jr. hands him a power suit gauntlet and Rex places it on, he tells Superboy, "Don't worry. This won't hurt but for a second." And with that, he begins mercilessly beating him with the gauntlet. And that is where this issue leaves us off. I was really worried that Jimenez wasn't returning for this book, but it turns out I had nothing to be worried about. Barberry's art style for this book is very much in keeping with that of the original Super Sons run, and furthermore, it is the perfect exact kind of art style that you need for this kind of fun, adventurous, all-ages romp that this book is trying to be. The artwork is really solid, guys. The writing in this issue is, of course, top-notch. Tomasi handles these two characters better than I think anyone I've seen tackle them in comic books, and at the same time, he manages to maintain all the key components and elements that made the original Super Sons run the beloved title that it became. In conclusion, guys, I really loved this book. I love that we get more Super Sons. I love that the quality was maintained. I love the idea of a bunch of alien kids wanting to pose as like younger counterparts of Earth villains to hunt the Super Sons. It's ridiculous and silly, but I just absolutely love it. As you can tell, I really enjoyed this issue. I definitely recommend it, and this week it's going to be getting 4 out of 5 GGs. But that's just what I thought, guys. Did y'all check this book out this week? What'd you think? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you like this video, please leave a like and share it with some friends. That's more important now than ever with everything YouTube's changing up on small YouTubers like myself. Also, if you're not subscribed, make sure to subscribe and hit that little bell if you want to get updates on all the dope content I'll have coming out in the future. Furthermore, guys, if you'd like to follow me on Instagram or Twitter, I will have the link for that in the description below. Thank you very much, children of the screen. I hope you all have a good one. And pick up Super Sons. Pick up Adventures of the Super Sons, number one. Just go out and do it. Thank you very much. I hope you all have a good one. Nerds come out. Super Sons, man. I'm so happy right now.